Yo, what's good, family? Appreciate y'all seeing us again. Y'all know this, my man, Young Napes, Bud, Hill, and welcome to another episode of What We Drinking. And today, we bringing y'all Brough Brothers Bourbon Whiskey. And this is a special bottle to me, because y'all know how I love bourbon. A new fan, by the way, but this is a black distilled bourbon. You know what I'm saying? This is a bottle for brothers, as it says, Brough Brothers, because once again, we have another black distiller, black company. I know I'm big on that. Y'all can see the shirt. I'm a big black fan, but I love all people. But you know, when my people do new things, it's just a beautiful thing. So let's just get into it, man. We got the Brough Brothers. Built, owned, and run by actual brothers. True born and raised brothers. I believe, Victor Yarbrough, Chris Yarbrough, and Tyson Yarbrough. Brothers born and raised out of Kentucky. I will say, now this is a first. I've never had this bottle.
Nope.
Maybe. Never once. So this will be a first time ever that y'all have been on the show. Neither one of us has had a preview of what this bottle tastes like.
Bottle hasn't even been cracked.
And let's talk about that, by the way, because I'm be honest with you. Man, this is just me. That's a beautiful looking bottle.
Yeah,
like, how y'all like that?
She's sexy. I ain't seen the bottle. Yeah. I haven't even seen. I've seen pictures. Let me see that.
Yeah, that's a beautiful looking. Like, when I look at, if you look at all the different bottles that, you know, bourbon bottles, so, I really do like this bottle.
Yeah,
like,
it's dope.
It looks good. Now, I will say this. Now, because of the lighter color, I immediately thought it was like, you know, it's going to be more of a honey flavor.
I like
it. Just because of the way it looks and, you know, it looks like honey. So, see that. Liquid honey. And why, you know, all the images.
Speakeasies and basketball.
Now, I do ask, horse racing. What's the box it about?
Kentucky, you gotta have.
Yeah, you gotta have horse racing. Yeah, it's Kentucky. Now, I didn't know what the boxing was about.
Crack.
Educate me, man. Educate me.
Can we crack mama called the play.
Damn, okay. See, education. This is why we do this.
Mama called the play.
I didn't know, man.
Yeah.
All I knew
was. You gonna get beat like Sonny Liston if you don't.
See? All I knew was the brothers. You know what I'm saying? That they put their own, you know,
basketball.
They put their own faces on their own bottle. I mean, representation.
Yeah, you've been in the field before. It's basketball and horses. That's what they got in the field.
Man, that's what's up, man. So, look, little background as we are. Little background for those who may not know.
Crack that open, man.
Crack that bottle open while we talk about it, man. Because I just want to talk about how.
I ain't just the current bottle.
Don't worry about it. You got the aggression behind it. You know what I'm saying? You might just you can stamp it.
You can make it sound as good as you want to.
Yeah, it got the aggression.
You
behind
got an
alternative.
Yes, somebody
called it Benson.
Right.
Open
the
box. Right.
For y'all that don't know,
now
if y'all don't know, I'm gonna peek y'all behind the curtain a little bit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Get the bottle there. Get the bottle there. Since everybody got jokes today, get the bottle.
He's so angry, man. It's so sad. But for all don't know, man,
Wendell's the angry one.
He's the angry one. You all see Bud is the angry one, you know what I mean, of the group. But I just love how they did, you know, Victor. So Victor Yarbrough, as which you may not know, he had a mission. And he being a importer, that's how he got started. So he was importing a lot of spirits within the UK. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Within the UK. But he basically said, why not try to bring more of the bourbon that they love from not just Kentucky, but wanted to make it global. So he took that business, you know, doing important, and they decided to make their own distillery and, you know, reach a different market, you know, UK market. And I think that's big for a black-owned company to want to get into an international market. And we all know how things can be in the U.S. when we talk about people of color. Let's just be real. But I think that's beautiful that he's larger than just looking at it from that perspective. He just wanted to put Kentucky on the map. And I think that's just super dope. Yeah. But we're going to have to see if this alcohol stands the test of time. Can this be a contender to, let's be real, because talking about your history, let's just be honest. Will this contend to be on the bars of within the bars, the cabinets, the shelves of our people? Will we put this in our cabinet?
That remains to be seen.
That remains to be seen, right?
But I think this was 35. Of course, we had to actually get it.
So I did get it.
$35 is what I paid for.
Yeah. Shipped. So Maryland, y'all need to change y'all laws, okay?
Right.
I am not happy that I cannot get any alcohol sent to me. We're in a pandemic.
Maryland is a non-delivery state.
That's ridiculous.
That's crazy. Yeah.
Who I need to lobby? Austin Brooks. Then we need to have a conversation.
You need to go talk to Hogan.
Governor Hogan. I need to holler at Hogan.
Yeah, I mean,
what's up, man? Why you come on now?
Gotta get my alcohol.
Come on now. You're building water levees in Ellicott City, man, for business. Can we just lift the ban on delivery? Yeah. Come on now. Total Wine deliver. I'm just saying. So anyway.
Not the Prince George's County.
No. Man, but listen. First off, I'm gonna just be real. So
get the nose.
Yeah, you gotta get the nose.
I'm gonna get this look.
And I smell. This smells good.
Okay, so now I'm gonna be honest.
Like
this
fresh fruit.
This
yeah, it
smells like fresh
it's
fruit.
Flowery.
Yeah, this is a floral note that now, pear.
Can I keep it?
This is a golden brown.
It's a little golden brown cell. Be gone.
Anyway, this smells good. But you know what this reminds me of? Smell wise, on the nose, King Alexander. Are you crazy?
It's lighter.
Yes.
It's lighter. King Alexander has a lot of
fruit.
But that had like, it was like fruit punch. Yeah, like this is like apple, pear.
Yeah, and why I say that, yeah, but get that fruity.
But how you gonna get like a fruit punch when you get?
I think I might smell of a pineapple in this.
Yeah,
I don't know.
You're just thinking of frozen margarita.
Hey, man.
It smells good. Like it's something I've never smelled before.
Actually, it's making me want some fruit right now.
Yeah, this is dumb. Hey, listen, hey.
All right, we talked too much. You wanna sip this?
No, brothers, bro, this is good, man. But fellas, let's pull up.
Another smooth sipper. Mm. Like a smooth sipper.
Yeah, you don't. What's the ABV? You don't get that Kentucky hug on the way down. It's 41, so you're looking at 82.
So basically 41. So it's in the same space as like the whiskey, right?
It's the other
lower joints.
It's a good like entry level into bourbon that if you want to go.
But this is
not good. The flavor is entry level. I'm just saying the ABV.
So all right. So let me just say this because we know we've reviewed like. We've reviewed other ones before. I like this. I like this comparative to. I would drink this over. I would drink this over like my. No, I wouldn't. Would I drink this over a Buffalo Trace? I don't think so. Would you?
No.
Buffalo Trace to me is a good.
I would drink this over Logic Crate. I would definitely drink this over Logic Crate.
The small batch?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I would drink this over Logic Crate small batch any day. I would drink this over Logic Crate small batch.
You know what this reminds me of a little bit? It's like a, I don't know if y'all had like a Basil Hayden.
I haven't had it yet.
So I've had Basil Hayden. So in terms of an entry level bourbon.
So it smells
like
better than
that's what I would point.
Is that make folks crazy?
I would say, hey, if you're trying to get into and you're transitioning from a yak. Or from, you know, whatever, it dark liquor-wise, moving over to the Basil Hayden, that's the perfect. Like, anybody that is new to it, I've always said, hey, you need to try the Basil Hayden. And usually, they're like, hey, you know, this is good. I've never had something like this. I always thought bourbon was old, boring, or whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
They go to the Basil Hayden, they're like, wow. And then they keep that on the shelf. Yes. Like, I agree.
I mean, color-wise and, like, proof-wise, they're similar. But I get more...
It's the sweetness.
I get more honey mm-hmm. and fruit.
You did get the honey.
Yeah. Okay. I get the honey at the back.
You did get the honey. Okay.
At the back end, I get the honey.
I thought I wasn't crazy.
And I think that goes into where you get this light...
That might be where I'm getting that smell. Color. It smells... So, I don't know if it sounds crazy, but it smells better than it tastes. That doesn't mean it tastes bad. But I love the way it smells.
That's the way...
You know what I'm saying?
Yes. And a lot of liquor is like that.
Maybe that's what's letting me down just a little bit. That when I smell it, tastes so good. My nose is not meeting the expectation of my palate. And maybe that's the key. But that doesn't mean that I wouldn't enjoy this.
It's one of the most unique smelling...
It's faint, but it is unique.
Yeah,
it's not real pungent. like other ones we smelled before, or like the King Alexander you spoke about earlier.
Right.
Go ahead.
But let's as far as whiskey. Can we caveat though? King Alexander is like was that $190 bottles?
$300.
$300 bottles. Yeah, right. $300 bottles. Big crazy. It's big boy. Yeah. It's big boy. So big bang. So let me just say, shout out to y'all for this, because I'm comparing y'all to a bottle that mostly nobody would ever buy. That's big. Whoa. So that's good.
Come on, man. Just don't go over.
I'm not saying that.
You gotta speak for
taste.
You gotta speak for your wallet. You can't speak for other people's wallet.
You're right. What's in your wallet? Right. I'm Capital One. I'm Capital One. I'm trying to check what's in your wallet.
Price is relative to what the bank account
says. Well, that's true. Let's be real, because we've all bought it. So yeah. We understand. You know what I mean?
Is this a buy? $35.
Yes.
What we listening to when we sipping this, Jay? Because this is, it's smooth, but it's also got a little bit of like party turn up feel to it. So like, it's a little louder than the whiskey.
This is a Devin to do. This is a Devin.
You got to
smooth.
But because it's so fruity, and it kind of makes me kind of smile. Like it doesn't put me in this state of relaxation.
This could be a T-Pain drink.
I might.
You want to go with the
Nuvo?
That's like Nuvo, baby.
You know what? I can do my shit. Yours right there, right? I've been trying to get rid of that shit for a long time.
You gonna hold on to that?
this some turn up type stuff. I might throw on some trap music or something like that.
Could be T.I.,
you know,
Ludacris.
It could be Ludacris.
Some Ludacris.
It would have to be a little higher ABV for me to have to throw some trap music.
For me, that's more.
It's got to be a little more.
Rubber band, man.
Yeah. I just feel like
wild as a Taliban.
This just makes me a little more turned up than that.
So you
immediately just walk in the party and start partying. I got to move.
I think this is a party drink. Like, this is the type of drink, if you in, you know, VIP and bottle service, I would recommend
but
this.
But that's why T-Pain, I like the dog. Like, this is him. You know, you looking for me. This is it. You pour this up, you have a good time. You have a good time with this drink. This is definitely, so you know what's cool about this? And you know me, I'm always big on this. Being such that this is a black-owned distillery, the way it tastes, the smell of it. Again, I grab this bottle in my hand like this, walk into somebody's crib, walk into the party. I pour this up. People are going to enjoy themselves. They're going to enjoy themselves drinking this.
Free look is always the best look.
That is very true. But it's the second pour that you see is most important. Because will they drink it again? We're going to drink it again if it's the only bottle that somebody brought.
Oh, yeah. That's getting drunk.
But if you got options,
folks will come back.
Would this get the second pour?
Come back to this.
Would you get the second pour for me?
Yeah. I'm talking about the second pour for the cats who don't drink variety. Remember, you know
that's
how we
that's
do here.
Going after, and I understand that.
Hennessy, Crown, Remy, do you add this to the list that it takes some precedence? That do we still ask for the, if you drink it, do you still ask for your Henny or for your Crown Royal?
Oh no, I mean,
if they gonna drink it straight, I would drink that straight before I drink any of that other stuff that you just said.
Yeah, but we know we mixing this. And you know what? Actually, you know what, brothers? Let me ask y'all a question. I know y'all are bourbon, but let's just be honest. You know what we do? We don't drink shit straight in our community. Not average.
They don't.
What we mixing with this? You gotta ask yourself that question. Do we gotta mix? Is that mixed with this?
Ice.
Where do we stand?
So, price point, buy for me.
Yeah, I mean,
at the price point, you buy this. If this was a $50 bottle, I would not buy this. If this was a $50 bottle, I would not purchase this. The price point of that bottle for me makes this a great purchase. Because you're going to enjoy it. It's going to be fun to drink. And I stand by that. We'll have fun drinking this.
If you can get it anywhere between $25 and $35, I would buy it. Anything over that.
Brobrothers.com. Yeah. I actually purchased this bottle off Reserve Bar.
Same.
But,
same.
You know, they do have their website. So we definitely want to promote that.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, $35.
It's a win.
It's a winner.
It's a win.
Thank you. From the DeVille.
Yeah, I'm putting my family onto this bottle. I am. This is definitely a purchase. I love it.
Do you work? That's a good bottle coming out the out the gate, as I say, coming out the gate, you did it right.
Yep. No question.
That smell that you got is amazing.
It's crazy. I mean,
that's almost like if you could bottle that and make that
this
alone. I'd wear that.
The look alone. I would buy this bottle.
Yeah, because the artwork. They took time and they said they wanted to make it to where they
felt water, like that. Cool water with the Brough Brothers.
Yeah. And I said, this is. Tell me that's not a bad smell. That if they could bottle that up, and,
man, this is good. Okay, now the more I drink it, I do like it. But I'm going past my nose now. I'm not sniffing no more.
I'm just drinking.
I know. I'm probably getting
sick.
I'm probably getting sick.
It's time to move on.
Yeah. Bro. Other than that, man. Hey, congratulations. This is a great bottle. Please get it. I mean, I think this is another one where when this becomes like a main
thing, see what it does with a little bit of water. I don't know if y'all want to do it, but I'm gonna do it.
I'm cool. I think I like the way it is. But
extended footage.
Y'all scared.
It's all good. Y'all scared.
Yeah, if you get this and it grows, this will be
adding water to the program.
Right, exactly. But I'm gonna be honest, man. I think that for this, again, when this becomes something that's popular, mainstream amongst a lot of normal, everyday, you know, whiskey, bourbon, alcohol drinkers like ourselves, this is probably gonna be another one that's gonna be hard to find.
Hey, in that price range, you
off the shelves.
Yeah, there's no way I would take Jack Daniel's No. 7 over that. There's no way I'd do it.
No, there's no way I'd do it. That's a big win, man. That's a big compliment, man.
I couldn't do it.
Yeah. And with that being said, hey, man, we appreciate y'all for joining us for another episode of What We Drinking. As always, hey, don't even worry about drinking responsibly. Just go ahead and keep drinking. Love.
Pull up.
Drink.
Headshot.
Drink.
Sit down.
Drink.
Stand up.
Drink.
Pass out.